Les premiers constats, c'est des équipes de Mogadiscio, c'est que.
Paradoxically, the first observation made by our teams in Mogadiscio is that malnutrition is not the most pressing medical issue today. There are other medical priorities, such as treating cholera and measles or vaccinating against measles.
La prise en charge des cas de rougeole, la vaccination.
Access to water is also a problem, so we need to organize the distribution of clean water to those in need. An additional problem is shelter, so we have set up distributions of non-food items in an effort to improve the living conditions of the displaced people.
Somali refugees head for Liban, the camp on the Ethiopian border. More than 20,000 people arrived in July, bringing the number of refugees in this vast series of camps to around 118,000. When they arrive at the camp, more than half of children under the age of 5 years are suffering from malnutrition. MSF teams are currently treating approximately 9,500 children in their nutritional program. A measles vaccination campaign targeting refugees under 15 years of age is also underway. Every day, over 1,000 Somali refugees arrive at Dadaab in eastern Kenya. With nearly 400,000 people seeking refuge here, the camp continues to overspill into the surrounding area. New arrivals settling in the outskirts of the camp are particularly vulnerable. MSF is working at several sites in the camp and is also scaling up activities on the Somali border, where teams are providing primary health care to families before they embark on the final 80 kilometers to Dadaab. Children with malaria pour into the health center in Boyele, a small village in northeastern Congo. Orally administered treatment is not always sufficient. This 4.5-year-old boy is anemic and is having convulsions, signs of severe malaria. MSF transfers him and treats him in Betu Hospital, where he is immediately given a blood transfusion.
En ce moment, nous travaillons à.
Our work is almost doubled. We had to add beds in the pediatric ward. We're right in the rainy season, which means there's a rise in cases of malaria, especially severe cases, with patients needing to be hospitalized.
More than 3/4 of the children in the pediatric ward have severe malaria. In the waiting room, patients are screened for malaria using a rapid diagnostic test. More than half are positive. Perched on stagnant waste waters, the village of Miramar had only one water distribution point.
Children were getting skin infections, diarrhea, and stomach pains. Doctors carried out a study and discovered that it was due to the water. It wasn't clean. So they started to work on a water sanitation project.
To provide the people with clean water, MSF decided to set up a new water supply system. First, this meant consolidating the dilapidated pontoons with new and durable platforms. Once these were in place, they could lay the drainage system. In a unique approach, local inhabitants actively participated in the installation and received training on maintenance techniques. Now every household in Miramar has its own water tank providing clean water. The same project is now being carried out in two additional neighborhoods in Buenaventura.